If you're looking at all the 911 emergency calls in the United States, about 1% of all of those are serious critical pediatrics, which is relatively rare. It's technically a good thing, like we don't want children to be sick with emergencies, but that rarity presents itself a training problem. Because pediatric emergencies are low-frequency, high-stakes events, training methodology to gain experiential learning, we have to basically create these experiences without causing harm to the patients. The most common way that we replicate that experience is through mannequin-based simulation. And that's how you train for different procedures, including resuscitations and how to assemble as a team. But mannequin-based simulation is costly both in time and effort. So that's when we built the simulation in virtual reality.
Doctor, this is a 7-year-old female who started developing a rash and difficulty breathing at a Chinese restaurant.
My belly hurts!
Doctor, I heard wheezing on my exam.
Doctor, please help my little girl.
Doctor, what do you want to do?
If we think it's anaphylaxis, I should intubate her before the airway closes.
Go for an intubate now.
I think virtual reality really complements the mannequins because in the VR, you have that emotional stress of a parent saying, like, my child is dying. That gets your heart racing, your palms are sweating, and you need to refocus with those elements there. So this mirrors what you're going to feel to some degree in a real-life emergency.
Yeah, it only took 18 seconds for you to intubate. That's, like, amazing. That you make mistakes, you learn the consequences, you get feedback, and then you try again to correct those mistakes. That's how people learn. In low-frequency, high-stakes events, there is no room for mistakes. The virtual reality setting provides a safe educational arena for you to practice, and practice over and over again until you get better and better. Those mistakes can be made there, you learn from it, and then when the real thing happens, you'll be ready.
You're learning where your knowledge gaps are, and that allows you to improve if you ever do encounter those situations again. And that should translate into you being a better doctor.
There's so many different ways to help children and children's health, and we owe it to the kids to perform at our best.